I know. I said I never was gonna talk about this again. I know. But wait, do you see this? It's magical. So, I'm sure you all know what this is, right? OnagoFly. Well, a very interesting thing happened to me the other day through email. Someone from OnagoFly contacted me and they said, "Hey, you." And I said,
"Yes."
And then they said, "We created a new Onago and we'd like to give it to you." And I was like, "Shut up! Just shut up!" And lo and behold, a couple days ago, look what showed up. It's the Onago One Plus with prop cards. It's like magic. Now, I have always liked this Onago. I really thought the product was gonna be very good when they first gave it out. And I still believe in it. I still think, because I know what type of controller is in here, that this has a lot of potential. That's the problem with this already. It has potential. Because sometimes potential is like rabbits. Sometimes they'll make babies and sometimes they won't. I don't know. Without further ado, I skipped the whole opening a box thing because I think you guys pretty much figured out. I'm pretty talented when it comes to opening boxes, right? I mean, I've got like a master PhD in opening boxes. So I skipped that because I was actually very, very excited to get this. And we're gonna take a look at what's in the box and then we're gonna do some comparisons. And then Sunday, we're gonna take it out for a flight. Hopefully I get the other battery by then. And I feel like I've cheated you guys out of watching me, the mastery that I am of opening a box. But here's what we got in the box. It was very nicely packed. This is really nice foam. Even got some velvet on it so you can rub it on your face like this and go, ooh, ooh, ooh. Aha, black velvet and a little boy smile. Ooh, now I know why she sung that song. Okay, back to what's in the box. So we already saw the charger. We get a bunch of propellers. Now these propellers are different. The new ones are rounded tip. These are bullnose. As you can tell by the difference in the design, about the same size, and I think that was 3 inches. And also, something very nice, which we'll get into in a second. So as you can see, looking at it, it's about one more size up from the other, from the newer one. So this is very tiny. It had very tiny arms, kind of like Tyrannosaurus Rex arms, right? Arr, arr, you're never gonna go fishing with these arms, arr, 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 but you could probably smack yourself pretty good with it. But still, this would never give enough lift to really sustain this thing. It would have to work very hard to do it, which is what it did. The second thing that you notice about this are the propellers. Like I said before, these are bullnose. These are just rounded propellers. As far as flexibility, they feel a lot more flexible than these. These feel very rigid, very flexible. And then of course you've got the prop guards, which as anyone who had the previous one knows, this didn't work out too well for a lot of people. You know, that goes without saying. The other thing that's pretty distinctive about the two is this one is lighter than this one. It's a noticeable difference. I can get a scale and measure it. You know what? Hang on a second. Let's get a scale and measure it. Let's go ahead and weigh them. 143 grams. Surprisingly, 208 grams. Funny how it feels lighter. I don't know, science. The next thing to notice on us is the legs. These are nice and rubbery. If this bounces, it has more of a cushion to land on. And I just like doing that, because it bounces nice. This thing bounces, yeah, it's like a rock. So, this is gonna land a lot better than this is. So that's a nice improvement. Next thing is this beautiful removable battery. You can see this is a 1000 milliamp battery. Now again, this is a pre-production sample, and I don't know, I'm sure the battery's probably gonna stay pretty much the same. This is pretty nice, I like this a lot. Because you have the ability now to get, obviously, proprietary batteries. You'll have to buy them from Onago. Smart marketing move. So, there's that.
The button to go on is right here. Yeah, press it.
The next thing to take a look at, you'll notice, which is very conspicuous, if you look at the old Onago, these collision avoidance detectors, I think they're IR, infrared IR, are not available on this version. And I don't know if that makes a whole lot of sense, because they didn't work anyway, so I would have hoped they would have improved them, but again, they didn't work very well. The next thing to notice on this is the way the camera is inside of this. As you can see, this camera sits less of a slant or pitch than this one does. This one is pitched out, probably, if I show you it this way, this one is pitched down probably about 15, maybe 20 degrees. This one is flatter. It's more forward looking. What I think this means is that this has a wider range of view versus this one that may have had a narrow view. This should produce a wider view. I'm not quite sure how much of this is going to get into it if it has a wider view, but we'll have to take a look when we start it up on Sunday and see what that does. And apparently the chargers have not changed. In fact, now I don't even know which one's which, because they, like a knucklehead, put them together. And now, but doesn't matter. The only thing that really changed is, here's the old plug that used to attach right up in here. Here's the new plug that will plug into the battery right here and recharge. So, this looks very promising. This looks very, very promising. Now, what I did was, I went out and I got 3-inch tri-blades. The difference of these propellers versus the old ones is, these you can squeeze off very easily. They are off. It's kind of pressure held. So when you put it on, just kind of squeeze it on there. And they've been known to fly off. I've never seen them fly off. Some people said they flew off. So these are self-tightening. So you can screw them on. I'll show you one over here. So when you spin it on or tighten it up onto the motor, there's markings on the propellers. And underneath the arm, which you probably can't see right now because the prop guard is blocking it, there's a letter and some instructions on how it spins. So that's not too bad. So that's a major improvement from the old style to the new. I'm gonna fly this twice. I'm gonna fly it with these blades on it, and then I'm gonna get the tri-blades and put it on there, because I've contended, as I spoke with Onago, I said, look, you know, you're not doing yourself any favors by having dual blades on something like this. If you want to offer it more stability, get tri-blades or get quad blades and put it on here. And then you would have more of a mass force, and the motors would probably run more efficiently with the multiple blades other than these two. So you really would want to have those on, as far as I'm concerned. I also remember a lot of people talking about the slot for the SD card, and it seems like they've taken a little bit more thought and put it below the seam here versus above the seam. So in my discussions with Onago, I told them, from a customer perspective, very disappointed in the customer service, very disappointed in the communication, very disappointed in the product itself when we got it. And still to this day, we don't have fuel sticks. What they said to me was, they will be watching my video, so I invite you all to put comments down, try and keep it on a business level, because these people do want to make things right, and they do want to give you something to replace this. I'm not sure what they had. I had discussed the possibility of a discount. They haven't said anything back to me yet. They were, other than that it's a possibility, and they were thinking about it. So if I were you, I would be kind, businesslike, and friendly, and let them know, if you wanted to buy this, what discount would you expect? And don't say free, that's not on the table. Second thing is, I would more than likely rather have extra batteries for this than my fuel sticks. So you people can keep them fuel sticks and send me extra batteries and we're good. I believe they've given these out to other people, so you'll probably start seeing some of these videos pop up. But if we can all be civil and be nice, I know a lot of you people are angered and mad and disappointed that you trusted something that didn't work. But OnAgo, I think, is really reaching out to people right now. I mean, they reached out to me. I think they reached out to a couple other people, and they want to make it right. So leave your comments below. Tell OnAgo what you think would be fair. Tell them what you do and don't like about what you've seen here. And then when we fly it, we'll get a really good look at what this is all about. Right now, I'm excited about it. I don't want to get my hopes up too high because of the first one, but I can't base everything on this, you know? Everybody makes mistakes. I mean, come on, look at me. You think I woke up like this? This was fingers in the electrical socket, man. Whew, that's what that was. So, once again, from the beautiful city of Tampa, Florida, in someone else's apartment. I don't know who these people are. I keep telling you that, you don't believe me, but they are. See, I'm stocking up on the fig Newtons for them. Mighty Thor, see ya.